Today's topic is about how to adapt Chinese medicine for use in the modern age. This is not easy to do. The herbalist has to know where does Chinese medicine come from. In other words, he has to understand the cultural and historical background of Chinese medicine. Here I have four examples. Let us talk about cholesterol first. Cholesterol is a relatively recent discovery by Westerners. As a result, there is no Chinese equivalent of cholesterol in Chinese medicine. Therefore, there are no Chinese herbs to directly reduce the cholesterol level. However, there are plenty Chinese herbs to indirectly help to reduce the cholesterol level if you want to use the Chinese approach for treatment. The Chinese approach for treatment is to strengthen the stomach and the liver so that the cholesterol inside the body will be broken down and pushed out more effectively. But you have to use Western methods to monitor the cholesterol level because there are no accurate Chinese method. And you have to follow a low-fat and high-fiber diet as recommended by many doctors. I'll be presenting a video about this later. The second example I like to give is hyperpressure. The ancient Chinese, if you read the Chinese medical textbooks, did not seem to see a direct link between a stroke and hyperpressure. That's why in the Chinese dictionary, you see the name Zhongfeng, which is the Chinese name for a stroke. Literally, it means you are being hit by the wind. So it's a very puzzling and inaccurate description. There is no accurate Chinese method to measure hyperpressure. However, if you live in a modern age, you can just use a simple instrument to do the measurement. Nowadays, at home, everybody can do that. There are no Chinese herbs to directly reduce the level of your hyperpressure. But then, if you're interested in the Chinese treatment, there is a Chinese approach, which is to calm the liver, to enhance the blood circulation, and to regulate the water in the blood. Again, for those who are interested in hyperpressure treatment with Chinese method, I'll be presenting a video separately. The third example is diabetes. Diabetes had been discovered by the Chinese long time ago, but it was not clear that they have discovered the cause of diabetes. The Chinese name for diabetes is tang niao, which is very interesting. If you have time, read the details on the right side of the screen, then you can see, you can understand where the name comes from. There is no accurate Chinese method to measure diabetes levels because it requires blood tests to do the monitoring. However, there is a Chinese approach to treat diabetes, which is to strengthen the kidneys, to enhance the blood circulation, to burn off the excess sugar in your blood, to nourish the blood, and to regulate the water content in the blood. For diabetes patients, you have to follow a strict diet, which is to minimize the sugar intake or the carbohydrate intake. There will be a separate video about diabetes, which I will present later. The fourth example I like to give is influenza, or commonly known as the flu. The Chinese have discovered the flu a long time ago, but they have an interesting name. In Chinese, it's called gan mao, and literally it means you catch something risky. One interesting thing is that the Chinese in ancient times did not know the existence of the flu virus because at that time the microscope was not yet invented. However, they didn't have to know the existence of the flu virus. They spent a lot of time studying the symptoms and the nature of the disease. So they come up with a good approach, which is very effective. The approach is basically to purge all the disease poisons from the body. This contrasts with the Western method. The Western method mainly focuses on using antibiotics to kill the virus. I wish to let you know that I have already published two videos about one about the flu, the other about coughing on YouTube already. You may want to take a look there.
I used to play around with cards, pacing at my call. But when I met that little girl, I knew that I would fall for a little fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool. She'd play around and tease me with her carefree devil eyes. She'd hold me close and kiss me, but her heart was full of lies. Poor little fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool. She cared for me, that we'd never part. And so for the very first time, I gave away my heart. Poor little fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool. Poor little fool. I was a fool. The next day she was gone, and I knew she lied to me. She left me with a broken heart, won her victory. Poor little fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool. Poor little fool, I was a fool. Oh yeah. Well, I played this game with other hearts, but I never thought I'd see the day when someone else would play love's foolish game with me. Poor little fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool.